Hey everyone, it's Dale here from Crazy Good PowerPoint. If you'd like to learn how to create this beautiful animated card slide in PowerPoint, then let me show you. Let's get going. First up, I'll right-click and select Format Background, so I can change the background color to a light gray. Now turn on the selection pane. I use this all the time, so I've added it to my quick access toolbar. Otherwise, you can go to Arrange and select it there. If you right-click it, you can see the option to add it as a shortcut, and you can do this for any feature you want quick access to. We're ready to go, so let's draw in a rounded rectangle and set the height to 4 cm and the width to 7 cm. We'll make the rounded corners less round by grabbing that yellow circle thingy and dragging it across. Duplicate this by pressing Ctrl or Command D and make the height 1 cm. Align this to the bottom and increase the width a bit. Now select this shape first and then select the smaller shape. Go to Merge Shapes and click Subtract. It will chop that piece off for you. Nice! We're now going to create these little 3D elements to add some depth. So select a triangle and draw it on the slide. Set both the height and width to 0.5 cm. And drag that yellow circle to the left to make a right angle triangle. Now hold down the Shift key and rotate it. Then align it with the guides. Create a duplicate and drag it to the right. Then rotate it the other way. We'll now add a gradient to the main shape. My template has remembered my last settings, which was set to purple. The other side of the gradient is the same color, but I've reduced the brightness by 25%. Let's add some contrast to the triangles. This one's okay as it stands out against the darker shade, so we'll make the other side match the darker purple by using the eyedropper tool. Perfect. Now draw a rectangle to fill in this space. To match the gradient, select the main shape and then click Format Painter. And click the new shape to apply the style. We need to make the gradient go the other way, so you can either rotate this or swap the gradient points over. Select this rectangle again and rename it in the selection pane. We'll be using this as a background shape, so this is a great way to identify it. And because we want this at the back, simply drag it to the bottom to change the order. Click the eye to hide it for now. Duplicate this triangle, place it on top, and stretch it to the left until it snaps to the other side. This is going to be our shadow, so we'll change the color to a dark gray and set the transparency to 90%. Select all the shapes and press Ctrl or Command plus G to group them. Then rename this, as we'll be creating more groups later. Now click the eye icon to show the background shape again. Looking good. Click the main shape and we'll enter our text. This can be whatever you need it to be. I'm using the Montserrat font, as it's one of my favorites. Increase the font size of the number and change it to the medium weight font. Fantastic! The next step is to create the white card that slides down. So select the rounded rectangle shape again and make sure it fits within the two triangles. Set the height to 10 cm, sharpen up the corners a bit, and change the color to white. We'll now add a shadow effect, so we'll select the offset bottom right preset. Increase the transparency to 80%, so that's more subtle. Then we'll select this dark gray as it has a nicer blue tone to it, and I'll bump up the blur too. Great, I'm happy with that now. Next, we'll add text to the card. My default text is white, so I'll change the font color. Now here's a nice tip. If you ever want to enter some lorem ipsum text as filler, type in plus lorem open and close bracket and press enter. Too easy. I'll now remove the text I don't need and reduce the font size to 14. We'll now edit the text options, but first, position the card so that it aligns to the top. In the selection pane, we'll move it backwards so that it sits between the two other shapes. Change the left, right, and bottom margins to 0.5 centimeter. Change the vertical alignment to top, and then increase the top margin to 3.6 centimeters. Now it's time to add our icon. So go to Insert, then Icons. Then I'll find the icon I need and click Insert. Then change the size to 2 centimeters. Change the color to a lighter gray and then align it to the center using the guides. Hold down Shift and select the white card as well, and then press Ctrl or Command plus G to group them. Then rename it to Text 1 and move it between the other shapes again. Fantastic! Most of the hard work is done now. Now we're ready to duplicate this, so select them all and press Ctrl or Command G to group them. Whilst holding down the Control button, drag it to the right to duplicate it, then do it again. We'll now use the Align tool to space them perfectly. I've set this as a shortcut, but you can also go to Arrange, then Align if you prefer. Make sure Align to Slide is selected, then click Distribute Horizontally, and then click Align Middle. Too easy. Now all we have to do is edit the text. To change the other two icons, simply right-click, go to Change Graphic, from Icons. Search for the icon and insert it. This saves you having to resize and realign it, which is handy. I'll do the other one quickly too. Let's now change the colors of the second and third shapes. I'll change this one to pink. But notice that the brightness settings resets to zero, so remember to reduce this by 25% again. Change the triangles too. Making sure that you use the eyedropper tool again to choose the darker shade on the second one. Select the text card, go to the selection pane and hide it. Now change the color gradient here as well by using the format painter again, and then reverse the gradient colors to match. Now click to show the text card again. I'll take care of the other one as well. It's looking great. By the way, if you're liking what you've seen so far, please hit that thumbs up button for me to show your support. And make sure you subscribe if you'd like to see more. Cheers. Let's move on. We'll now need to ungroup them using the shortcut Ctrl plus Shift plus G, or Command plus Shift plus G. We now need to get these shapes layered correctly. So in the selection pane, we'll drag all the groups labeled Group Purple to the top. We'll also rename the colors as we go. In the next layer below, this will be for the text cards. And the bottom layer is for the background shapes, which I'll rename now. And you'll notice that these cards will now slide up and down between the other shapes, but we don't want to see it coming out the top. So we'll create a shape to mask this and hide it. Select the rectangle and draw it along the full width of the top, making sure you cover the colored shapes. Rename it to Mask. Use the eyedropper tool to match the color of the background. Now move the mask so that it sits below the colored shapes, but above the text cards. Let's see how that looks. Perfect. We're now ready to build our morph transitions so that they animate in for us. Select all the text cards and move them up so they're out of view, being very careful to keep them aligned. I'll close these panes as we don't need them anymore. Select the slide and press Ctrl or Command plus D to duplicate it. On the second slide, we can bring down the first text card. Because we had originally aligned it to the middle of the slide, we'll use the Align tool to align it to the middle. Too easy. Now to Transitions and select Morph. Looks fantastic, but let's reduce the duration to speed it up a bit. Much better. Now duplicate this slide and bring the second card down. And follow the same steps for the third one. And there we have it. We're looking crazy good now. You can download this template for free using the link in the description below. If you like this video, make sure you subscribe if you'd like to see more. And please let me know in the comments below what types of videos you'd like me to create in future. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you over in the next video.